Hey YouTube, how's it going? It's Ryan GG49 here. I just recently received my Pieta 1851 revolver to go along with my Uberti. My Uberti cost a little more than my Pieta, but I wanted two just to, because reloading is a bitch. So basically I got two. Because this one was actually relatively cheap, I can give you a website if you IM me. Where you will not find a better price, I guarantee you. I got this one for $189.99, and I'm not kidding you. The website is called Sportsman's Warehouse, and they have the best, most inexpensive stuff. I don't want to say cheap, because it is great quality stuff. This gun case that you're looking at right here, I got for $10. It's got the foam and everything inside, you'll see here in a little bit. I got an Outers cleaning kit, 32-piece cleaning kit, which comes with all that. I believe I got this one for $20. My whole purchase ended up costing $250 and $265, I think. No. Yeah, $265 for shipping around there. Got some ammunition. Even though I have my Uberti is a 36 caliber, so it's true to its form. However, in 1851, they didn't have 44 caliber revolvers, which is what this one is. So, even though it's a 44 caliber revolver, I still love it, you know, even though it doesn't hold to its historical value. So, 44 caliber, quantity 100, picked this up for $12. Can't find better ammunition, especially with black powder. You can get 100 for $12. You know, you can't beat that. But it's hard to film and do all this one hand. Go tell that long tongue liar. Go and tell that midnight rider. Tell the rambler, the gambler. It's a mini pizza box. Alright, there we go. There's that. I already had one, but I thought, why not two, you know? It's a little cheap traditions, powder flask. But again, guys, this isn't a joke. This actually happened to me. No shit. I'm telling you the truth here. When they say don't load directly into the cylinder, they mean don't directly load into the cylinder. Thank God it did not. The fire did not travel up to here and destroy everything and basically blow up my freaking hand. Okay, what happened was I was at a competition. We were doing fast shooting. It was just a friendly competition. We were reloading. Well, I shot those six shots off really quick. And there were some hot embers in there. So what I did, you know, they say there's hot embers. They're not kidding you. There's hot embers. And I put it in there. As I was putting it in there, it went up here and just basically just shot out like that. So that was scared the living shit out of me. I'll never load out of a flask again. So I went ahead and bought a powder measure. This powder measure is actually really cool. It's really cheap. I got this one for $6 again at Sportsman's Warehouse. Well, this doesn't work for flintlocks, my 50 caliber, but you need definitely a lot more powder for that. But as you can see, it goes all the way up to 50 grains of powder. And what it does, and it's just a measure. Let's say you want 30. Oops. Lost it. There it is. 25. Okay, I guess we're doing 30. Just twist that little thing until it tightens, and there you go. You have a measure. So now you can just load, and you don't have to worry about. So yeah. So this doesn't turn into a grenade. Now let's. Okay, I covered everything. Let's get on to the pistol. Like I said, this isn't the best. I mean, as good quality as a Uberti, but it's excellent quality. I mean, I got the brass. A Pieta. Now, it does have the walnut grips, okay, real sturdy, real smooth. If you've ever owned a Denix replica, that wood is crap. Don't buy a Denix replica. I mean, they're only for wall hangings, but they're crap. Don't buy one. I have one under my bed, actually, and just don't buy it. Okay, here we go. So, I doubt you'll be able to see this because of the quality, but right here, black powder, only 44 caliber, so... It's a real heavy gun. That's what you're going to be seeing when it's cocked. There's your sight picture. a little wobbly, but yeah, the cool part about these, I don't know if this was on the old ones, haven't done that much research, but you can load all six safely by putting it in the middle and you don't have to worry about anything. So when you're ready to shoot, pull all six back, or pull it back, and you're ready to fire all six. Another thing with these guns, guys, don't dry fire, because you're going to ruin those nipples. Okay, you're going to ruin every single one of those nipples. And not only that, I promise this is safe, you're going to drill a hole basically right in there to where it won't even strike your cap. So definitely don't do that. Not good. The cool part I like about the Pietas is that they have the naval battle scenes, which is what you would find on a Colt, a good quality Colt. And it's actual stamped like it would be back in 1851. So there's no modern stampings on the cylinder whatsoever. Everybody knows about the loading feature. Okay, there it is again. Pieta, made in Italy. I wish it really didn't have that. And if it did, they should put it right here. Underneath. Right there, underneath the charging lever. But anyway, guys, like I said, if you want links to all of these, you know, all of this, the cleaning kit, the case, the weapon, the grenade, your powder measure, your ammo. The only thing I don't recommend y'all buy online is caps and powder. The reason why I say that is they're going to charge you for hazardous material for shipping, and that's around 25 bucks. You do not want to be paying that, I assure you. Okay, so there's that. Again, guys, this is Ryan GG49. I hope y'all enjoyed. One more thing, it's blued. The brass is good quality brass. I've seen it tarnished on other videos, and I'm very happy with that tarnish. The grips, great quality. Trigger, easy trigger pull. Again, you have these modern stamps, which I really wish weren't here. Kind of kills the trueness of the gun, but the cylinder definitely makes up for it, that's for sure. I'll probably be coming out with a video on, you know, just different stuff on how to load these, because this is all I shoot is 1851s and 1860 armies, which I love the navies, because look at this. We have this octagonal barrel. It's just beautiful. Polished perfectly. I mean, you have the bead sight, you know, your sight right here. It's just, everything about it is just amazing. And you have a certain, you know, sense of history when you load it with black powder, and you just can't beat these. Anyway, guys, like I said, this was about a $260 purchase. If you got 300 bucks for your birthday or whatever, I am me. I'll show you what to buy. I'll provide the links. But anyway, I hope y'all enjoyed. This is Ryan GG49. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace. You can run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Sooner or later.